Hello, this is Professor Zaman. Welcome to Hasan Zaman educational video series. In this video, we learn how to solve circuits using nodal analysis when there is no series resistor with voltage sources. There could be one such a case or multiple cases in a circuit that a voltage source doesn't have a series resistor. Interestingly, just like super mesh for mesh analysis, this technique is sometimes referred to as supernode by some people. The significance of this naming probably will be somewhat obvious when you do this exercise. Let's take a circuit somewhat similar to the circuit we have been using so far in other videos. So this is our example for this video. We have a 96 volt source with a 4 ohm series resistor, another 36 volt source with 6 ohm series resistor, and a current source, let's call it 2 ampere. And we have a resistor here of 4 ohm, and there is a voltage source of 4 volt. So this is the source of the complication in this circuit. This particular voltage source doesn't have a series resistor with it. So in this branch, we cannot find current using Ohm's law. For example, here we can find the current using Ohm's law in this resistor, but we cannot do that in this branch. So that's why we have to use this technique, which some people call supernode. To do nodal analysis or solve a circuit using nodal analysis, which some people also call node voltage method, you have to first assign voltages at nodes which have at least 3 branches connected to them. Let's find out how many nodes we have where at least 3 branches are connected. So we have a node here, 3 branches are connected. We have another node here, 3 branches are connected. And we have here, actually, multiple branches are connected in this node, ground node. In every circuit for nodal analysis, you have to assume a reference node, which is usually the ground node. So this is our reference node, which has a voltage of 0 volt. So do not have to assign any voltage here. But we have to find out the voltages in this node and in this node. So let's call this voltage V1. And let's call this voltage V2. There are a couple of other nodes in this circuit. For example, this is a node between these two elements, and this is a node between these two elements. But we do not have to assign voltages to them. This is not to say you cannot assign voltages in these nodes. You can. If you assign voltages, there will be 4 voltages. 1, 2, then 3, 4. And you will end up with 4 unknowns. And it is more difficult to solve circuits with 4 unknowns. So we will assign voltages as fewest as possible. And the technique is assign voltages only on nodes where at least 3 branches are connected. Let's write down the nodal equations. This is node 1, say. So for node 1, if you write KCL equation for this node, the way we will write the equation is sum of all outgoing currents equal to 0. To make this a little more complicated, so you don't get confused when you see a more complicated circuit, I'm going to change this circuit a little bit. I'm going to put this here. I call it I1, I2, I3. So I can write I1 plus I2 by I3 equal to 0. I1 is this way, so this is plus, minus. What is the voltage drop in this resistor? Voltage here is 0 volt at this node, because it's the ground node. And what is the voltage above the resistor? It is V1 minus 96. Some people make a mistake, which is not very uncommon. So they think this is 96 volt source, so voltage here will be minus 96 or something like that. That is a mistake. So voltage at this point is V1 minus 96. And voltage at this node is 0. I1 is equal to V1 minus 96 is the voltage at this node minus voltage here, which is 0 volt because the ground node, minus 0 over 4. If I had the resistance here instead of here, the value would come out as the same actually. The reason in that case, the voltage difference would be V1 minus 96. Okay, so now, and what is I2? There comes the problem. We do not have resistance here. So we cannot write equation like this to find I2. But what about I3? I3 we can find. I3, you see, I3 is downward. But actually current is upward, 2 ampere. That means I3 will be minus 2. It's very clear. So we can write I3 minus 2 equal to 0. The problem is here. We cannot write a current value using Ohm's law for this branch. So that's why we have to use the supernode technique. Technique to use here, whenever you see a voltage source without a series resistor, you have to assume the voltage source is not there. You have to short the voltage source. And I'm saying this is just mentally. I'm doing it here really on the board, but if you just visualize it mentally, that will be sufficient. You don't have to really remove it. Let me remove these currents. It's kind of confusing. Now, this node and this node seem to be same node. It's like a bigger node. It's a super node. But actually, they are not at the same voltage. There is a voltage source here. So the technique is when you have a voltage source without a series resistor, you have to kind of combine them. Basically, you have to assume this is a bigger system like this. I'm going to put back the voltage source because it is really there. It's not like it's not there. So if you short it, you know what node you have to write the KCL equation for. But you put a circle like this to know that they will be merged for the sake of writing KCL equation. And we will have to write KCL equation for this system. You can write KCL equation for a node or for a system. This is a system. How many branches are connected to the system? One branch, two branch, three branch, fourth branch. There are four branches connected to the system. So let's write for this system. We have this current outgoing. This is correct. And this outgoing current is actually minus 2. And this outgoing current will be, for this node is V2. Do not use V1 here. That will be a mistake. So plus V2 minus 0 over 4 plus, in this branch we have a series resistor with the voltage source, so we can use Ohm's law, not like this branch. So what is the voltage difference? For outgoing current, the drop will happen this way. So this voltage V2 minus this voltage, what is the voltage at this node? 0 plus 36 is 36 volt. So that is V2 minus 36 is the voltage difference in this resistor for current this way. So V2 minus 36. We have to account for all the branches that is connected to the system. This branch, this branch, this branch. So four terms, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you miss one term, your answer will be totally wrong. So this is our KCL equation. We have two unknowns here, V1 and V2, but we have only one equation. So we have to get other equation. And we will get that equation from this system. For simplicity, I'm going to remove this I1, I2, I3 thing. When you have enough practice, you can write this equation directly. And the second equation comes from this here, where we see V1 is higher than V2 by 4 volt. So this is our second equation. This is first equation. This is second equation. Students do this mistake that they think this is a 4 volt source, so voltage here will be 4 volt. So they think V1 will be 4 volt. Some even think that V2 will be minus 4. Those are wrong. A voltage source does not set the value of the voltage at a node. It only increases or decreases. So it only saying voltage on this side will be higher than V2 by 4 volt. That's why we wrote V1 minus V2 is equal to 4. And if we solve these two equations, you get the value of V1 and V2. So I'm going to put V1 is equal to V2 plus 4 in this equation. Come here, it will be V2 is 46.5 volt and V1 will be V2 plus 4 50.5 volt. Okay, so we have found the unknown voltages V1 and V2. Now you can find all the currents. So voltage V1 is 50.5 volt, this is 50.5, and V2 is 46.5 volt. So voltage here is 50.5 volt, what is voltage at this node? It will be V1 is 50.5 minus 96 equal to minus 45.5 volt. So note, voltage at this node is minus 45.5 volt. This is also an interesting point where we can learn Ohm's law a little deeper. Ohm's law says current flows from higher voltage to lower voltage in a resistance. Or other way, voltage drops in the direction of the current. So voltage which is higher? This voltage is 0 volt and this voltage is minus 45.5. Actually, 0 volt is higher voltage. Negative voltage is considered lower voltage. So current will be flowing from this higher voltage to lower voltage. And what will be the amount of current? Current will be higher voltage 0 minus lower voltage minus 45.5 over resistance value 4. So this current will be 11.37 ampere. So this is the upward current flowing from higher voltage 0 volt to lower voltage minus 45.5 volt of 11.375 ampere. This current is given 2 ampere upward, so there is no reason to find that. So what is the current here in this branch? We do not have a resistor there, so we cannot use Ohm's law to find this current. So what we will do, we use KCL at this node to find this current. Current is flowing in here to this node, 11.375 ampere. And this is 2 ampere, so this must be going this way. What is the value of this current? This two together, 13.375 ampere. And what is this current? Voltage here is 36 volt, and here is V2 is 46.5 volt. So this current is this way, 46.5. Minus 36 over 6 is 1.75 ampere, this current. And we have to find this current. Voltage here is 46.5, here is 0. Difference is 46.5. So this current will be 46.5 over 4, 11.625 ampere. Okay, so we have found all the currents and all the voltages in this circuit. Now hopefully you'll be able to solve circuits using nodal analysis, even if there are voltage sources without series resistors like this. I encourage you to watch our other videos. Thank you for watching.